Welcome back to the Dark Cosmic Universe. My name is Avian Savage. Welcome to another cosmically insane toy review. This should be the final Superpowers McFarlane toys that I picked up from Walmart. Probably it was like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Can't remember when. But finally getting to the Black Manta, which is the fourth and final one that I purchased. If you are new to my channel, I do toy unboxings. I do lots of different unboxings. I review action figures, play sets, vehicles, all different types of collectibles, and I also display some of, not all of them, but some of the collection that I've been collecting over the last 40 some odd years, thereabouts. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe. We are knocking on the doors of 900. Thank you guys for all my new subscribers. Thank you for my current subscribers. Thank you for my vintage subscribers, those who have been here from day one, and those who have commented on my poor unboxing skills from 2 years ago. Hey, I appreciate the comments. Again, please like, subscribe, leave comments, share the videos, watch the videos, check out my YouTube shorts. No, I don't have shorts that have YouTubes on them. Don't forget to talk about the videos at work. Why not? While you're at the water cooler, it's got to give you something to do and talk about. Don't forget all those important things. Check out my links in the description. I do have a eBay store, which I do sell vintage and retro t-shirts. So those would always help the channel. All right, so here we are. Let's take a look. It is, I'm going to unbox this here or get it out of the plastic here. It is the Black Manta figure from Superpowers. Here's the card art. Very cool. I don't think I talked about the previous card art and how cool it was. Again, McFarlane Toys, very reminiscent of the Superpowers line way back in the 80s. And we've got some vintage Superpower figures to also take a look. This is the line currently that McFarlane Toys has made. So really, really cool. I'm pretty excited about it. They show most of the figures except for the exclusive figures. But here is the checklist, which is pretty awesome. Here's some of the vehicles that have been made. Here are the legals, all the legal stuff that they have to put on there, the packaging. This is the UPC code. If you are looking for this character and possibly might be at your Walmart, pause the video right over here. Also, here is the file card on Black Manta, if you're interested in learning a little about that. Again, this is the early deep dive. You can always check other videos out where people do more specific and they get more into, you know, detail of who Black Manta is and all the origins. And I humbly implore that you guys keep looking because it's always fun. Hey, check out comic books, check out the graphic novels, watch some movies that feature the Black Manta and all that stuff, because Aquaman definitely did. All right, so here's the figure. We're going to take a look at the figure. Looks really cool. I got it from the card, the card art over here. Taking it out. Normally, I just take these out because I know people don't like to do the ASMR, all that, you know, the crunching of the plastic. I'm hoping I don't break it. This thing is in here really, really tight. But here is the figure. Now, this is the second release, if I remember correctly. I believe they did a blue and I think it was a purplish color. I might be wrong, but this is more of the traditional Black Manta black suit over here. Looking really cool. I think so, in my humble opinion. I totally missed out on the original one, and I might be wrong with the color scheme, and I do apologize. But here is the figure. Let's take a look, see how tall he approximately is with the old Black Manta. And he is close to that 5-inch mark. Looks really cool. It does have some articulation. So here is the mask on the Black Manta. We do have some articulation in the arms. We've got some in the legs over here. It does have a knee joint over here. And let's take a look at the backpack. Again, this is a silver black version of the Black Manta. I love over here. He's got his backpack over here, the apparatus that's providing air so he can look menacing, go underwater. And he is a nemesis of Aquaman. I do not want to bring my Aquaman figure out, but we'll take a look at some previous figures that I did collect. Now, I'm thinking this was from The Brave and the Bold, and yes, I have not cleaned him off. He still has some dusties on him, but really, really cool. So you can see the comparison of these two particular figures. We'll take a look at the back. He's got that oxygen mask. The Brave and the Bold figures featured this, like, I think it's like a hexagon shape, so you could put things, add, you know, different accessories in there. But really cool. Again, I can't say enough. I wouldn't have gotten this figure if I didn't really want it. Well, you know, maybe I did. I don't know. But I think it's really awesome. Again, the Brave and the Bold one compared to the McFarlane one. Now, the Brave and the Bold one is a lot taller. And I figure while we've got that aquatic theme, I busted out my King Shark over here. But over here is the Devil Ray from the Justice League Unlimited series. So this character was highly inspired from the Black Manta. Maybe they didn't have the licensing for the particular figure, but you can see where they were going with it. And I just had to get the Black Manta figure. I mean, Black Manta and the Devil Ray figure. So I'm going to focus more on the Black Manta. But here's the Devil Ray figure. You know, again, very similar. He's got that, but it's more of the Justice League Unlimited bodies over here. But still, I think a really cool figure. And while I was thinking about the Black Manta, I was also thinking about the Legion of Doom. So I decided to get my Lex figure from the Justice League Unlimited series. I believe it was Mattel. And I might be wrong, but I think someone did say, hey, it's Mattel. And it's been a while since I've seen these figures. But very, very, like I said, cool just to show off some things in the old collection here. But it's a really cool figure. Again, it would have been cool if he had some accessories. But I know that there are 3D artists out there that will print 3D accessories. Oh, I know. People are like, can I just see the King Shark? I know. But this is not the Sylvester Stallone Rocky Balboa Shark King. What a cool figure. I was like, there's another character that Aquaman could go against. But when I'm thinking about these figures, I'm thinking about the Legion of Doom. And I've talked about the Brainiac figure that just got knocked over. How many times can my figures get knocked over in a video? Please leave comments. I'm okay with that. Also, I decided to break out some of the vintage. All right, here we go. Superpowers. Justice League figure, and I'll go over some of the names. Superpowers, that is Mattel. That looked like the Superpowers one. We've got the Parademo over here, so let's go to some names. So over here, this is the Darkseid figure that I chose to put with this. I should have gone with the original one, but I kind of like this one. You know, but then if I ever do find the original one, and he's got that cape, and I'm like, I mean, I know it's Jack Kirby, you know, the Jack Kirby-esque Darkseid figure, which would have been really cool. Okay, let's see if we can get the names right here. And we've got, oh my gosh, I know we got Kalibak, Steppenwolf, Desaad, that's who it was, I had to remember the name. Mantis over here, the Justice League Unlimited Mantis figure. Back here, Tyr over here. So we've got, here is a McFarlane figure that is also with the Superpowers line. This is the animated Superman Brainiac figure. So Brainiac. Again, we've got the Black Manta over here from the Brave and the Bold line, which I really, really loved. And he's just not standing up really well. Anyway, so I thought I would put these figures together. I did get a message from someone, or not a message, but they left a comment. They're like, oh, when you put Superpowers, we thought you were going to put the originals on here, not this McFarlane-esque stuff. So I decided to put some smiles on some collectors over here so they could see some of the original Superpowers figures that I do have in my collection. That's not all of them, but again, I thought I would, you know, display them together. And if you do have these figures, you can definitely see how they kind of all go together. Even throughout the years, they look really cool. Not knocking the Justice League movies when they had Steppenwolf and he looked like a ram or whatever. When I think of Steppenwolf, the uncle, I think of him looking like that with his hydro blade, or is it hydro axe or something axe. And I can't remember. Leave it in the comments. Like I said, it's 8:30 at night and my mind is kind of fried here. But I thought I would show some of the really cool figures all together. And again, I'm hoping that McFarlane decides to go with the Legion of Doom, and we get a really cool, Lex Luthor figure, because he was part of it. Other characters would be kind of cool to see. I'd like to see was it Catwoman? I think she was in there. I'm trying to remember off the top of my head all the characters. We did get a Sinestro. Maybe we'll get a Toy Man. That would be kind of cool, with the Legion of Doom. Maybe we'll get a playset that looks like the Legion of Doom playset. If not, I'm just going to have to get the Imaginext version and then just kind of stand my figures with them, because Imaginext did also do a Hall of Justice. I do have the Superpowers one, but I don't know where it is at the time, so I'm not going to put it up here, but I do have it in my collection, which is kind of cool. All right, so that's it. So again, in my personal opinion, humble opinion, toy opinion, the Black Manta looks really cool. I think the first one, it was, I'm trying to think of the colors. I know there was a blue in there. I think there was a some kind of purple or something. But this is more of the dark suit, the black and the silver and the red. He looks so menacing. And again, put him next to Manta Ray. Devil Ray that he's standing next to. I think he looks pretty awesome, just like my thing. Anyway, so if you guys have any of these in your collection, please let me know. Thank you guys for checking out all the shorts that are on here. Like I said, I went to Dollar General today and I saw some Halloween stuff. Halloween's coming up and I'm like, yes, I am getting excited about Halloween. But we also got to do toys too. I will be doing some Halloween prop videos, a little something different. I did pick up some stuff from the Dollar General, One Piece definitely in particular. And I just kind of want to save it. There were some other things that were picked up from the Elephant's Trunk, the flea market. I didn't think about that. So we got some vintage stuff from Halloween stuff. So it won't be a toy review. It'll be like, collectibles and display stuff. So that will be coming up hopefully soon. I got to kind of just, time it and see what is going to be in the collection. Like I said, so this is going to be the final figure that I've collected thus far. I'm hoping that McFarlane releases some more figures. Maybe we get some 3-packs so that I can add to my Justice League figures. I can add to my Legion of Doom figures, to my the Justice League themselves. Maybe some Super Friend stuff. I do have some Super Friend figures, and I will be doing that also in review too, because I've been looking and people like the Super Hero videos that I put on here with some of the figures. Like, whoa, haven't seen that figure in such a long time. That is so awesome. Thank you. You're welcome. I'm glad I could do that. And I'm glad I was able to show off some of the stuff. Again, when it comes to the superpower figures, I'm not going to squeeze the legs so you can see their super action, because they are super old. And I think there's a rubber band in there, and I don't want to snap those rubber bands. I'm going to keep the figures as is. If later down the road, they get another, superpower characters that were released in the line, I'll probably pick them up, integrate them with the figures over here. So superpowers, the McFarlane superpowers. I've got, one and two in here. But you can see how they kind of all blend together. At least I think so. And even though, 30 years ago, they look really cool, And I'm just excited. So yeah, take a, step back, look at the figures and go, that's what I do. And I'm glad I'm able to show that off there. Anyway, that's it. That's the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching the videos. Thank you guys for checking out the shorts. I so appreciate that. Thank you guys for hitting the subscribe button. We're going to get to 900, knocking on that door of 900, and then 100 more subscribers. And then we will break that 1,000 subscriber barrier. That's going to be awesome. That's going to be cosmically insane, my friends. Definitely. And again, thank you guys for leaving all the comments. I love it. And I do apologize if any of my things that I say are inaccurate. Like I say, I am the cosmically insane fountain. I gotta think here. the fountain of misinformation. Sometimes I do that when I talk to it, because I just kind of get excited about it, just like you guys get excited watching the videos here. That's it. That's the end of the video. My name is Avian Savage. This is the Dark Cosmic Universe to my Dark Cosmic family. If you are subscribed, you are part of that Dark Cosmic family. You are part of the elite, most awesomest, yes, awesomest, our most awesome subscribers out there. Thank you guys so much again. Those subscribers, those people who are part of the Dark Cosmic family, are my cosmic comrades, my cosmic cosmonauts, my insane toy collectors, my dark cosmic Pokemon collectors as well. And what do I say? Say it loud and proud, everyone. All together, stay cosmically insane, my friends. Keep collecting those action figures. Keep collecting those Pokemon cards. Keep collecting all those collectibles. Return back here to the YouTubosphere. Return back to the channel here so we can talk toy even more. Again, we will see you soon. I hope you guys enjoy these videos. I enjoy making them for you, even though I'm like tired as anything. I want to go to bed, but you know, you guys are more important than my sleep. Thanks again, everyone. Thanks for checking out the videos. And again, I will see you guys soon with some more videos, some more toy reviews, and all collectibles considered. Take care and stay well.